In a stunning eyewitness account that has sent shockwaves across the entire professional world investigating the past, the words muttered by the eyewitness as he was diving off the coast of Israel was as follows. I saw it. Then I kept on swimming for a few meters. Then I realized what I had just seen and continued to dive until I could touch it. It was like entering an Egyptian temple at the bottom of the Mediterranean. The Israeli vet who made the sensational discovery was diving on the Israeli coast on the shores of Atlit. An investigation was launched on the location, and lo and behold, an artifact dating to 3,400 years old has been recovered from the site, and the Israeli authorities were straight on the phone to the Egyptian Antiquities Authority, and we all know what that means. The artifact that has been recovered was an anchor inscribed with hieroglyphics, and it is now on display at the Israeli Museum in Jerusalem. The head of the Israel Antiquities Authority Maritime Archaeology Unit, which was contacted after the discovery, explained that the site was already known to the archaeologist and other objects were previously found in the same premises, and this piece presents the typical shape that was common for anchors in the Bronze Age, with a hole at the top and rounded corners. However, this was not the intended purpose of such a stone. Similar anchors from this time have already been found on the coast of the Mediterranean. However, what sets this anchor apart from all others is the quality of the decoration. The most interesting part of the decoration is the image that shows a woman riding on a board. The symbol of her head identifies her with the goddess Seshat, the ancient Egyptian deity of riding. Based on the style of hieroglyphics, the anchor was sculpted in the 15th century BC. That is, it is more than 3,400 years old, and this is the results that are being pointed out by the conservative. The creation of the anchor would refer to the 18th dynasty, the time of the pharaohs who founded the new kingdom and led to the maximum expansion of ancient Egypt. The valuable material used in the stone and the quality of the inscriptions means that this was probably the decorative relief of a very prestigious building in Egypt and later used as an anchor, probably washed into the Israeli basin through the process of time, preserved in the sand, and recently washed free by a freak storm in the region. This goddess did not have separate temples dedicated to her, but usually appeared on the walls of other major shrines, recording the pharaoh's regional years, taking note of the booty brought back from military campaigns, or helping the king take measurements for the establishment of a new holy site. The experts involved in the investigation describe her as a divine scribe, librarian, record keeper, and engineer, and the identification of the goddess is also strengthened by the hieroglyphics that accompany her image and proclaim Seshat's traditional divine attribute, mistress of the house of books. Because it is incomplete, the rest of the inscription is difficult to decipher, but experts think it may have something to do with the recording of war loot. During the 18th dynasty, the pharaohs who founded the new kingdom and led to ancient Egypt's maximum expansion, so the inscription could have adorned one of the many royal reliefs that were set in temples across Egypt at that time, but nobody knows which temple that might be, and the investigation continues, much to the excitement surrounding the new discovery. During a recent interview regarding the discovery, one expert says that all we can say for now is that at some point that shrine was renovated, abandoned, or destroyed, and the relief was deemed obsolete, allowing for the reuse of the raw material. Whether the repurposing of the Seshat inscription had something to do with these historical events is one of the questions that experts hope to answer in the future. We can say, though, that such a richly decorated anchor is an unparalleled find, but what do you guys think about this? Comments below, and as always, thank you for watching.